Good morning, Panthers. Today is Monday, January 30th. I'm Whitney Emanuel.
And I'm Jalen Rogers, reporter from Channel J106 for Proudly TV. Congratulations to the academic UIL team for the first place win at the Cypress Park meeting on Saturday.
That's right. Sophie Friedman, Dylan Gunner, Julia Herder, Autumn Kirkman, Rohith Nara, Summer Wynn, Spencer Vignair, and Daniel Young all came in first in their events. You can see the parlor for the complete results.
This week's quote of the week is,
before you are a leader, success is all about growing yourself. When you become a leader, success is all about growing others, by Jack Welch.
Sometimes being selfless is how you can become a leader.
Now let's go to Maddie with our sports update.
Thank you, Whitney and Jalen. Girls basketball swept Bush last night. Varsity won 69-45. Raven Adams scored 12 points. Taylor Thomas and Ilea Fontenot scored 21 points. They have now locked in their first ever district championship. Congrats. All teams play Friday against Travis. Good luck. Boys basketball won 57-53 against Bush, with Isaiah LeBlanc scoring 20 points and PJ Haggerty scoring 11. Nice job. They will all be competing this Friday against Travis. Good luck. Girls varsity soccer beat Austin 4-0. JV Purple also won against Austin 8-0, and JV White won 3-2 against Brazoswood. Good job, girls. Boys soccer swept Austin with JV White scoring 1-0, JV Purple 2-0, and varsity 4-1. All soccer teams face Bush on Friday. Now back to you, Whitney and Jalen.
Thanks, Maddie. Juniors, if you ordered a t-shirt before the holidays, you can now pick them up in Dr. Gage's room. Congratulations to the Photo of the Week winners, Blaine Simmons, Abby Teary, and Ryan Williams.
Their best images were selected by their photojournalism classmates. Are you interested in earning college credit by taking one or more AP exams?
Registration is now open, and most exams cost $94 each to take. Early registration closes on February 28th, so see the parlor now to register.
Whitney, are you ever looking for a place to try some comfort food?
Always.
Well, you're in luck. Let's go to Caitlin as she goes to Agu Ramen for a new a la carte.
Hey Panthers, it's Caitlin Katuza here, back with another episode of A La Carte. On today's episode, a few of my friends and I, we went to this place called Agu Ramen, which is located in Sugar Land in the town center. And my older sister has tried it before and she said she really, really liked it, so I decided to check it out for myself. So let's dive into it. Chili cilantro something. I can't recall the name. This is definitely a 5 out of 5. I really like this place a lot. And then we had an appetizer and it's like these little spicy rice balls. And not spicy rice balls, those fried rice balls. And they're really good.
Are you a YouTuber?
Wow, that looks so good. I have to check it out.
Have any interest in culinary arts, firefighting, maybe cosmetology?
These skills and others will be available at the new Career Tech Center next fall. You must apply by February 5th in order to take these courses. You guys, Valentine's Day is just around the corner. Looking for a gift to give your crush?
Student Council will be selling carnations for Valentine's Day and will be at all lunches through February 1st selling carnation orders for $2 per flower. They will be delivered February 14th during fifth period.
This weekend, I really just want to relax and watch TV, but I have no idea what to watch.
Really? Have you heard of this show called The Punisher?
Not at all. Is it good?
I don't know, but maybe Kian can answer that for you. Let's shoot to him as he does his film review on The Punisher.
What's up, guys? This time I was going to talk about Punisher Season 2. We'll be right back. because I thought it had really good action and good character development, and it really improved upon season one in pretty much every way, minus I think the villain was a little bit weak, but I think it's pretty acceptable when the action stuff is as good as it was, and the story was good. I thought it was a huge improvement. So imagine my surprise when I come home today and I see reviews from Rotten Tomatoes, Metacritic, and Collider that it's garbage. To summarize, they're basically all complaining about the show being repetitive and boring and just repeated the first season. But it's not at all. It's new. Some stuff repeats, but that's because Frank isn't over everything that happened in the first season. Whatever, I thought season two was really good, and I think if you like season one, you should watch season two. It expands upon the story, and the action's even better. So, yeah, that's all I have to say.
Seems like your type of show?
It might. I'm gonna have to check it out. Speaking of having to check something out, how about the High School Musical? Ridgepoint's Fine Arts Department will be presenting Disney's High School Musical for its last couple of days.
That's right. Interested in seeing it? Come Thursday, Friday, or Saturday at 7.
Based on the popular movie, High School Musical is perfect for the entire family. Discount pre-sale tickets are $8 for students and $12 for adults. At the door, tickets are $10 and adult tickets are $15. Tickets are reserved and can be purchased on the Prowler, and they will also be sold at all lunches during the week.
Let's go to Cammie as she asks Ms. Coleman 10 questions.
Oh, hey, Ms. Coleman.
Hey.
Do you mind answering a few questions for me?
Sure.
Okay, so what is your full name?
My name is Vanessa Marie Coleman.
Okay. What was your first job?
I guess I would call it like on the recovery team for McFrugal's, which y'all know as Big Lot today.
Big Lot's, that's cool. What's your favorite movie?
Okay, it kind of dates me, but have you ever heard of A Few Good Men?
No, I have not.
What's his name? Tom Cruise.
Tom Cruise,
yeah.
Nice.
I like it.
What about your favorite song?
It depends on which day it is. I like all types of music.
What is your zodiac sign?
Sagittarius.
Sagittarius, nice. I'm a Libra.
Yeah. I don't know what any of that means, but.
Your dream job?
I think I kind of have it this year. Anything teaching.
And your favorite holiday?
Easter.
Why Easter?
It's like a time for new beginnings. You get to start again.
Aww. Well, thank you so much for letting us interview you, Ms. Coleman.
Thanks for walking with me.
Thanks, Cammie. The course selection fair is today at 6:30.
Plan to visit a variety of booths and talks with teachers, sponsors, and other students regarding the classes you can take next year.
If you're interested in attending night school to recover some credits, registration for the first session is going on now. Just see your counselor. Well, if you're looking for a little push to go see High School Musical, here's Macy with a little sneak peek of it all.
Thanks, Macy. I'm already excited.
To all of those participating with the blood drive, it's today at 6. Don't be late.
Ridgepoint High School will be offering the ASVAB on campus for interested 10th, 11th, and 12th graders on February 5th. Students can sign up on the ASVAB page in Naviance. Deadline to register is January 31st. Make sure to tune into our broadcast every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday to get all the information, news, and fun videos you will need to see. Well, that's all for today, Panthers. I'm Whitney Emanuel.
And I'm Jalen Rogers, reporting from Channel J106 for Proudly TV.
Have a great day, Panthers.